Café con leche para mí. Huevos rancheros.
Pásame la salsita, ¿sí?
Sí, como no. Pásame la manteca, las tortillas.
You speak American? Could I have a coffee? Coffee?
Con leche o sin leche?
You want a black or with cream?
With cream.
Con leche, por favor.
Yeah, leche. Leche. Are you American?
That's right.
You know this town?
Sure. Not much to know.
Is this the only bus depot?
Mm-hmm. Somebody supposed to meet you here?
Yeah.
You got an address? If you have an address, you can walk over instead of sitting around. Won't be far.
Well, he lives outside town. Between here and, Maya something.
Maya Tamos.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you're gonna have to wait. Must have his own transport, else he would have rode the bus in.
He'll be here.
Mm-hmm.
Estos pájaros cantarán sus alegrías, señorita. Mire, este es como usted. Y este que le enseñé al principio.
Pues volando por el mundo, lo ven todo. Cantan triste a veces.
Y a veces con alegría.
Cómprelo, señorita. Son los ojos de Dios. Ellos saben mucho más que nosotros. Fíjese que cuando no ven, cantan más bonito todavía.
You're a spunky little thing.
Those little guys are called miselitos. Supposed to be the sweetest singing birds in Mexico.
Lléveselo y se lo dejo ciego. Gratis.
He's offering to blind it for you without charge and throw in a free cage.
Blind it? What do you mean, blind it?
Yeah, well, it never did seem like a lot of encouragement to me. But they think that it makes them sing better.
How do they blind it?
Well, they heat up a kind of needle thing.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, no. They don't stick it in its eye. They just hold it close enough to
fry it.
Cloud it.
That makes all the difference, right?
Señor, no le interesa.
No me lo compra siempre.
No, señor. Perdóname.
¿No le gustó?
Muchas gracias.
De nada. Pájaros.
Pájaros. No. Pájaros. Pájaros.
Your friend hasn't showed up. Maybe you got the wrong date.
Hmm? He booked the ticket.
Uh-huh. What's his name?
Teschmacher. Delbert Teschmacher? He's my father. The thing is, I wouldn't know him if he came up and bit me on the knee.
Might be a hungry dwarf. You said he lives out by Maya Tamos?
Yeah, something like that. Well,
I'm going out that way. If you'd like, you can ride around with me and I'll ask about him. Can't be too many Delbert Teschmachers up in those hills. No hassles, that's the truth. My name's Wilson. Eugene Wilson.
I'm Margo.
You never finished telling me about your father.
Never started.
I know. I'm kind of pushy. I don't mean to be. Just want to hear the story, I guess.
I don't remember him too well. I was about 6 or 7, I guess, when he left. Every so often, he used to send my mother money. Nothing regular, you know, nothing you could count on. I mean, months would go by, there'd be nothing. And then all of a sudden, just plop, there'd be a few bucks. He'd send like 17 bucks or 11. Once he sent $4. Weird. Don't you think that's weird? I mean, to send 10 or 20, but 11 bucks. Weird.
You start thinking of smaller numbers when you live down here a while.
Well, about 4 or 5 years ago, the money just dried up, and my mother died. And I guess, 2 or 3 weeks ago, I went through Safford. That's where my mother used to live. And I kept her P.O. box. And there was this letter in it from him. And the thing was that the letter was to me, not to my mother. And it was from him, and it had a bus ticket down here and a letter. It said he had something to give me. Substantial was what he called it. Like a legacy, you know? Hey, I didn't kid myself. I mean, a guy who sends 11 bucks, he ain't gonna be, But who knows, you know? I didn't have anything better to do, so why not? South of the border, down Mexico way. Is that what you wanted to hear?
Best story I've run across in years.
Where are we going?
This is the road to San Juan de los Colores. I show a movie there tonight.
Out of this truck?
Yeah. Got a little generator, runs a projector. Isn't too noisy. Won't be 5 minutes. Gotta get permission from the priest.
You gotta get permission from a priest before you can show a movie?
It's just routine. He always says yes.
I see you have for us another tale of illicit passion, Eugenio.
Well, you know how the posters are always a lot worse than anything you ever see.
Yeah.
You remember the film about the nun?
Ah, see, the Temptations of Maria.
Well, the posters look terrible, but all that happened was she went skiing.
Ain't me, kid. Ain't me.
I sometimes think that putting the pleasure between a woman's legs was clever, but not wise. But then he gave us the sacrament of marriage to correct that.
Sounds like he's experimenting.
Would you like to be an experiment of God?
It depends on how I turn out.
Eugenio. You have to remember that God loves each and every one of us as though there were but one of us to love, no matter how we turn out.
I'm gonna have some questions about that when I come back.
Well, don't forget I'm not God. Dios es la respuesta para la cual no hay pregunta.
How's that?
Ah, you see, you have to improve your Spanish and your soul at the same time, huh?
Thank you.
Priest says he's a gringo, has a place on the other side of the valley. Guess it's gotta be him.
Did he say it was a big place?
He's never been over there.
Are you sure this is the way?
Well, this is the way. I'm not sure if this is the place.
You think this is it?
Well, it's the only place I see.
Said in his letter he had a modest estate. I was thinking maybe gauchos and cattle and a hacienda.
Well, hacienda, that little dream.
Aren't you going in? You come all this way.
Yeah, I'm going in. Anybody home?
Angelina. Angelina?
It's Margo. Are you Delbert Teschmacher?
Margie, you made it. What day is it?
How come you got your foot in a birdcage?
Oldest dumb thing in the world. Hit a tree with a blunt axe, bounced off and caught me between the toes.
Anybody home? Margo?
Yeah, we're in here. Come on in.
You traveled with friends?
This is Eugene Wilson, who works in town. He gave me a ride out here.
Oh, many thanks, Mr. Wilson. Been expecting my little Margie for some time now. Told my Evangelina to keep an eye out for her. Maybe I told her an American. You know, sometimes when I think on Margie, I think American.
What'd you do to your foot?
Oldest dumb thing in the world.
He hit his foot with an axe. He should see a doctor.
I don't trust doctors. Not after what they did to a friend of mine. You don't call yourself Margie anymore.
Margo. I hate Margie.
Well, I'll try to keep it from slipping out. Now that Margo's here, things are going to be just fine.
Well, you know, I think this is just great.
Thank you.
You take care of that foot now.
I gotta get my case.
Tell you what, I'm gonna be back in 3 days. If you want, I'll give you a lift. Chances are you're gonna be settled in rolling tortillas by then.
Don't bet on it.
as to us and our trip.
Where are we going?
I'm going to take you back to the bank, introduce you to my manager, and fix it so that all that money I got there is rightfully yours.
You mean you never took it out?
Never touched a cent.
We'll have a fine trip with that money. Might be my last, so I need to make it a dandy. We'll go some places. Where would you like to go?
Las Vegas.
Never been there. All right. Las Vegas it is. And Frisco. We'll go to Frisco.
How come you never took the money out?
Money's funny stuff, Margo. Money you can't touch till you touch it right. Like a dream you're being here. I hope as ever dreaming it don't wake up.
Hey, what are you doing? Can you be resting that foot?
In this cage all night. It's a freedom.
What are you doing?
Collecting a nice pan of eggs for your breakfast.
You keep your eggs out here?
That's where she leaves them.
This is kind of a lot, don't you think?
Less than snake would take.
You got snakes around here?
Oh, snakes is nighttime beings.
I admire a chicken sitting out there in the dark. Being a bird's tough enough. But when you can't fly, well, that don't seem like any fun at all.
You got to be pretty damn spunky to be a chicken.
Brave as a chicken? Is that what you're telling me? Where is this bank of yours?
New Mexico. Up north from Roswell.
How long you had the account?
Well, now, let me see. I guess I must have been about 19 when Tevis and Scobie and me were partners. Just wild kids we were. It must have been all of 45 years.
Well, you must have earned a pile of interest on your money in 45 years.
Your money, Margo. I saved it for you. You see, darling, I always expected to come back and get you. But your mother, Hannah, she was mean-hearted.
She had plenty to be mean-hearted about after you left us.
When I left, I wanted to take you with me. She just laughed a little.
Oh, Jesus.
What the hell is that goop she's putting on your foot?
I stayed around till you were about 7. And I want you to know, Margo, that the best times in my life were spent with you. And one morning, I just upped and blew down the road like an old newspaper.
You gotta see a doctor.
No doctors. Not after what they did to Scobie. There were 3 of them. And not one of them would lift a finger. The last one washed his hands over and over again till Scobie died. Tevis would have killed the men in there. Only I begged him.
Daddy, are you all right?
I dreamed about Scobie last night.
Who the hell is this Scobie you keep talking about?
I was robbing a bank in Del Rio, Texas. First bank we ever robbed. First and the last.
You robbed a bank? When?
Oh, long before you were born. Bad times were plentiful, and Tevis said, we might as well be pirates. Dry land pirates. Brave as a chicken I was, but Tevis said I'd do just fine.
What happened?
Scobie died. Tevis got 34 years. I got 12, kind of being young and doing nothing but driving. Ain't nothing to be proud of. Except it's all buried now. All except me.
mistletoes or whatever.
Catch many with that stuff?
Oh, hundreds. The Bachelina makes the best gum of anybody around here. Old Indian secret.
You sure that's not what she's putting on your foot?
I better get you more room. It's a bigger cage.
De las cadenas del cielo, un pájaro nunca es libre. A bird is never free of the chains of the sky. That's what they say here.
Yeah, you know, that's exactly the kind of bullshit I expect from people who blind birds to make them sing better.
Things been going hard for you, Margot?
You give some shit, don't you?
Well, no. Hardly a day's ever passed that somewhere, someplace I hadn't thought about you.
You're a goddamn liar. You took off when it suited you. And sometimes when you were loaded, or you saw some kid looking cute, you thought, oh, I wonder where my little Margie is. But you sure as hell weren't wondering where this Margot was every day. And you got me down here with some load of crap about how you had something to give me. Because you knew I'd never come to this dump unless you said some pile about money. Go on, admit it.
I just wanted to see you. Nothing wrong with that.
How come you left it so fucking long?
All right, it's true. There are times when I didn't think on you. Oh, long times. And suddenly, out of nowhere, you'd pop into my head and I'd be your father again. That was always better. You're the only treasure I got, Margot. And every time I think about you, I get a little bit rich.
Then why didn't you send for me years ago? You got this money you say you have. You could have set yourself up in business instead of this. I mean, how much is it anyway?
I never counted it myself. But 18,000, Tevis said, near as you could figure.
This is the money you stole? The actual money you stole that what's-his-face got killed for and the other guy and you went to jail for?
Well, I couldn't spend it, you see. Not with Tevis and Scobie gone. Tevis tried to break out four times.
Would you shut up about them? What are you telling me? You just walked into a bank and then you deposited. Is that what I'm supposed to believe?
No. We buried it. Tevis said he wouldn't put his money in the bank, not with fellas like us around. Oh, that Tevis, he was one for getting a laugh. Even old Scobie, propped up in the back of that Packard, holding his guts in. He got a laugh out of that one. We tried to find a doctor to help Scooby. You got to understand, we were scared bad. We drove on all that night. Got off the oil. So we wrapped up the money in Scooby's slicker. We buried it under that tree and we drove on. Scooby died that night. Tevis wouldn't bury him no place except in Oklahoma with his folks. 2 days later, they caught up with us. And I, for one, was glad. Scobie began to smell real bad, and we still had a long ways to run. It's all yours, girl. I just wish I had more. Angelina with her own picture show, and me
with my own daughter. Let's drink up. Ah. How she loved to swing in the rain. It'd rain and she'd come running to me and say, swing me, Dada, swing me. And I'd wrap her up in my yellow oilskin and we'd swing back in two and the rain would be tapping away outside.
You remember any of this?
I remember the tree. It didn't go no place.
She was too young. Daddy's little treasure she was.
Well, it's really something you two caught up with each other. I think it's great.
You see, we're planning to take a trip, she and I. As soon as this darn foot of mine quits starting. Oh, this dumb thing in the world.
Well, I'll drink to that. Did your foot quit and hurting? And your trip with Marco.
When you get to my age, journeys will be gravely considered. Get what I'm saying, Eugene?
Well, sure.
Dad, do you think you should be drinking so much with your foot like that?
You're right. I'm going to quit. Get ready for my trip. There you go. Thank you. You're as big as Scopey. Took up a lot of room, I can tell you. We had to dig awful deep to put him down under. Angelina. Smell it. My foot, do you smell it?
No, sir. Here you go.
Enjoying the movie?
Yeah. It's good when you can't understand what they're saying.
Si quieres vivir, yo ya me cansé de comer puros nopales y tunas. ¡Ay, te quedas solo!
Was he a man got shot in the gut? Shot in the gut? Shot in the gut? Or was he a man got shot in the gut? Down in Demerara.
You shouldn't be drinking. It's bad for your
help
foot.
Help kill the smell. Can't you smell it?
What happened? What happened?
Look at his foot.
Oh, Jesus. Burning up. Evangelina!
I don't smell like Scobie, do I, Debbie?
No, sir. No, sir. Come on, help me get him in the truck. Come on, move. Will you move? Come on. Feet first. Come on, let's go.
Don't bury me, Thomas. Till you get me home. God damn them faggots! I'm not Scobie. Why am I Scobie?
You're not Scobie. Scobie's dead. You're my daddy.
I smell so bad. You won't throw me out if I smell bad, will you?
No. Scobie's dead. Okay? I'm gonna get you to a doctor.
No doctors. My Margie'll be there. She'll fix it.
I'm here. I'm here. You asked me to come and I came. I'm here.
Journey.
We're almost there. Are we almost there?
Just waiting for your little treasure.
I just got here. I just got here. You sent for me and asked me to come and...
This is the death certificate. I think maybe you would want to give this to Evangeline.
What does she want with it?
Well, she was with him for a long time. Doesn't have a marriage certificate, nothing like that. I think she put some store in the paper.
What does it say?
It's the cause of death. Insult to the heart due to blood poisoning.
Insult to the heart. Doctor's got some good lines, I tell you. I'm sorry.
And I am sorry for you also.
Maybe he wouldn't have died if I hadn't come.
No. You come in time to let him free. That is what he has sent for you.
That bus ride back, I can tell you.
Stick around. Give yourself a chance to...
I got a family to support.
You got a family?
Sure. I got a Visa card. I got a MasterCharge. I got 3 gas cards. Department store cards. Oh, crying out for Mama to feed him.
Oh, yeah, I remember them little bread snappers. What kind of work do you do?
I'm a dancer. I'm a stripper. I take my clothes off.
Oh. Well, that's pretty interesting.
Beats keeping chickens where you can't find the eggs. I dance good and I take my clothes off good. And I don't do love numbers. I don't go bottomless. You know, last year I almost made the chorus at the Tropicana.
What are love numbers?
Where you pretend to fuck on stage. So what do you got to show a girl last night?
Well, it depends on what you got in mind.
Well, why don't we get drunk and go dancing?
Well, first part I can manage.
Good.
The second part, I'm not too sure.
Well, hell, I can dance well enough for the two. Here, just go with you. Now, show me where the action is. Huh?
Well, I do know a jukebox that has gringo music. It's,
Hola.
Oh, my God, Millie Jackson. What the hell are you doing down here? Thanks. Don't you ever stop loving me, baby. We got a paying audience tonight. Did you hate me?
Didn't think of it.
Well, I hate myself.
So, what are your plans?
Do you think my father was crazy?
Well, he was a little goofy there towards the end, but I don't think he was crazy.
He said some pretty crazy stuff about money.
You mean like calling you his little treasure?
This was before that, when you weren't there.
I like that about swinging you under the tree all wrapped up in the rain.
He said he robbed a bank.
He robbed a bank? When?
Way back before I was born. So it sounded like the Depression or something.
How much did he get?
12 years.
He got caught?
Yeah, him and two others. One of them died. Scobie. The name. Makes you want to scratch yourself. Better change into something more comfortable than what I wore on the way down. Those pants nearly cut me in half.
I'll drive you to the border.
Why would you drive all that way?
I enjoy your company. Be a trip for me. I could use a trip. Okay?
Okay. God, I can't believe that they blind these little birds just to make them sing better.
I was blind once. My eyelids stuck shut, some kind of infection.
Holy shit, you must have been terrified.
Uh-huh.
How old were you?
About 11. Didn't make me sing any better. I sure got good at praying.
And your prayers were answered?
I remember I was sitting up in my bedroom waiting for my breakfast.
And all of a sudden, it was like the whole world just appeared.
Thank you.
It was like, you know, magic pictures in my head. Only I didn't remember the names of the things I was looking at. I'd forgotten the names. Thanks.
When I was in seminary, I remember reading in the Bible, somebody got his sight back and said, and he saw men as trees walking. Well, I knew exactly what it meant.
Well, how long did you stay in the seminary?
Right up until Lucille came along.
What would make you want to go to the seminary anyway?
Well, thought I wanted to be a priest.
Ah, I got it. And then Lucille came along and defrocked you, right?
So, we came out to California. Lucille took acting classes and I got various jobs. Finally ended up working with Pacific Exterminator. Catchy title, huh? Yeah, you know, roaches, termites, those guys. I can tell you stuff about termites.
Don't. Tell me about Lucille. When did she start screwing around?
How'd you know that?
Never mind. Tell me about Lucille.
Well, she got a part in a movie. She's pretty good, too. So at least the main actor thought.
How'd you find out?
Lucille told me. She said she thought our relationship was more platonic than sexual.
Shit, I wish I could come up with lines like that.
One day I was rolling along to my local liquor store, and this BMW pulled alongside. It was Lucille. She was sorry she stopped me when she got a look. I'm not too impressive when I've been drinking. I think it's the eyes.
What'd she do?
She wrote me a check for $500, got in her BMW, and drove off.
It's not bad for your first handout.
That's what I thought. But I knew it'd be downhill from then on, so I cashed a check and I left town that very day. Didn't tell anyone. Didn't shut off the gas, nothing, just
blew down the road like an old newspaper.
Exactly. That's exactly so.
Putting on the miles, Margot.
Oh, you look great.
Yeah. Hey, thanks for the ride. I had a good time.
Okay. Me too.
I got it.
Look, I'd take you on through, but those guys would tear my truck apart.
Wait till you see what they do to my suitcase.
Yeah, but you got more in your suitcase than I got in my truck.
Take care of yourself, Eugene. I'd kiss you, but it'd ruin my face.
Good morning. Do you have anything to declare? But you have medical papers for it. All livestock require them.
Livestock? It's a tiny little bird, for Christ's sake. Look at it.
Oh, I'm sorry, but the regulation is quite clear. This is livestock.
Oh, I don't believe this shit. Sir, what do you do about all the birds that fly over the border every day? I mean, do they have medical papers?
It is a legal requirement.
I told you my father robbed a bank? Well, he told me what he did with the money.
I thought he got caught.
He did. Before he got caught, they buried it.
Buried it? Where?
In some old ghost town, north of Roswell, New Mexico. Behind a building that used to be a bank. They wrapped the money in a slicker, and then they buried it under a cottonwood tree. That's what he said, anyway.
I heard him talk about a cottonwood tree.
Almost $20,000. I mean, wouldn't it be something if it was still there? It'd be like a...
Your legacy.
Yeah.
$2 a week.
What's the rent?
$75 a week. $77 if you rent the linen. Why, she's been in a motel you're gonna find around here.
You charge for greasing the place?
You Manuel?
No. Manuel was my wife's first husband. He killed himself with a car. My name's Joseph.
Well, mind if we talk this over, Joseph?
Sure enough.
Yo.
That sure is a fancy truck you're driving. You two honeymooners or something?
What do you say?
It's a dump.
What's cheap is right about that.
If you're honeymooners, this would be the place. Used to be a honeymoon trailer. I fixed it up when me and my wife first got married. Tropical style.
What do you say?
We'll take it. For a week.
Thirty-six ghost towns are marked on this map.
36?
Mm-hmm.
Shit, I thought there'd be two or three.
Well, 36 isn't so bad. Man at the Chamber of Commerce said that most of them aren't there anyway, just blew away.
Well, that's a big help. It would take us months.
Can I have one of your cigarettes? Mm. No, come on. Let's see. Let's say we see 10 a week. That's 1 month.
How much money have we got?
Last count, 160.
Well, that'll last about 2 weeks.
So we get jobs.
Jobs?
Yeah.
When are we gonna look for ghost towns?
On our weekends, days off.
That's gonna take us years.
Oh, come on, be like a hobby for us. I mean, plenty of people go hunting or fishing on weekends. We got good jobs, get a nice, decent place to stay. It won't be so bad. Oh, hell, Margot, it'll almost be like real life.
Well, I saw a bar on the way in that was advertising for go-go dancers. Can't be a hell of a lot in town this size. Then I could get top billing in there as easy as falling in a hole.
Try.
Well, what the hell?
She arrives in all her splendor every night at 9 o'clock. And a cherry is a crosstown bus that stops right down the block. The old piano minstrel plays a song as she walks in. And the queen of the silver dollar she's home again. Yeah. She's the queen of the silver dollar. She rules the smoky king.
She's new, ain't she?
That's right, yeah.
Thought so. This whole place has changed.
And the jesters flock around her and bite to win.
Wonder who's drinking out of her cup. It's got you on the rocks. Clean glass if you got it.
My hips are bigger.
Can I be two and a quarter?
You weren't here last time either, were you?
But you wanted his drinking out of my cup too, huh?
But I found her, and I won her, and I brought her to this world. Yes, I'm the man who made a queen of a simple country girl. Is a throne, and the jesters they flock around her and they fight to win her favors and see which one will take the queen of the silver dollar.
Your girlfriend, she's cute. She's a real good turn. Customers like her.
You two been together long?
No, not long.
Look,
what's your first name again?
Eugene.
Well, look, Gene. There's this thing I wanted to mention. You know, while you're working, you know, behind the bar, I don't want you to make it obvious that you and Margot are, you know, together. That's all. And Margot, she's a pro. She tell you yourself. Customers sitting there looking at this piece, shake her thing up there, and they're thinking a lot of good stuff about her. What I'm trying to say is, it could be a real downer to find out she's laying the bartender. Kind of spoils the illusion, to get my drift.
Blind man on a galloping horse can miss it. How far out of Roswell did he say?
He didn't. He just said north. Wouldn't it be great if we found it the first place we looked?
What's out back?
Zilch.
No tree, huh?
No.
Map says it should be along here somewhere.
Maybe it blew away like that other place.
No bank, no tree that I see. You sure you're remembering right about what he said? See anything back there?
Ah! It was a fucking rattlesnake! It went... Looks like there may be more down there.
OK.
Yeah, I think from now on you gotta wear some boots.
Yeah, and I want a gun.
All right.
I wanna shoot those bastards with a gun. Aha! Eugene, do you think if you'd stuck to your original profession, you'd be a saint by now? I mean, who was that saint that got tempted in the desert, huh? Wasn't that Saint Eugene? Eugene?
Saint Jerome. This truck's taking a beating out on these roads.
We can do it when we get the money. Huh? I know what we'll do. We'll buy a convertible, and then we'll go to Las Vegas and check into Caesar's Palace and order room service. You know, those little tins and nuts and tabs and club sandwiches.
What if we don't find it?
Well, we'll find it. You just keep this truck running, we'll find it. I mean, it's out here under a tree someplace. Trees just don't blow away, do they?
No. No, they don't.
Well, that's what he said, under a cottonwood tree wrapped in a slicker.
He also talked about another cottonwood tree. One he used to swing you under. And he said he wrapped you in his slicker to keep you from getting wet.
That was a different tree. That was when I was a kid.
Wait. He also called you his little treasure, Margot. You know what I'm saying? I mean, he was kind of delirious at the time, and with you being there and everything.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. You're saying it's all bullshit. You're saying let's quit because your fucking truck is getting
bounced around. No, my truck has nothing to do with it. I just don't want to see you getting fixed on something that may not happen.
You're a quitter. Do you know that about yourself? That's why you're so fucking easygoing.
Well,
you've quit already.
Hey, wait.
Hello there. Everything all right with you folks?
We heard shooting. Anybody get in the way?
No, we're fine. We're just hunting beer cans.
Where are you folks heading?
Hi. My name is Sadie.
We're going out towards those two ghost towns. What were the names, Margo?
You mean Dollar and Tishomingo.
If you folks are heading up to Dollar, stop by. We could have a drink. It's getting toward that time of day.
Maybe next time. I think we better be heading on. I don't want to be out here when it gets dark.
Come by and see us. We'll have a drink.
Longer. We don't want to get stuck in the boonies, do we?
How'd you get it?
I got it from Chuck, the manager. He finances autos. He gave it to me real cheap. Real cheap.
How cheap?
$1,200. It's got everything. It's got AM, FM radio. It's got wide ovals. It has factory air. It's got power steering. It's loaded.
I'll get you. All right. Come on, Joseph.
Well,
bye.
Bye, Joseph.
So I thought that we were gonna get out of this place and we got some bucks, huh?
Look, I didn't pay cash for it. God, I'm paying it off at $200 a month.
That's 6 months worth.
Well, actually it's eight with interest.
Eight.
Hey, honey, when we get the money, you know, we'll just pay it off.
We may not find the money, Margot.
Oh, God, don't start that shit again. Look, it's my bill, all right? Don't worry about it. I'm sick of eating dust. I'm sick of pounding around that heap of scrap metal of yours. Look. Chuck says that there's an apartment that we can rent behind the club.
I don't want to live behind the club in Chuck's apartment. I don't even like you working there in the first place.
What's wrong with me working there? You work there.
Not naked, I don't.
I don't go naked, goddammit. I wear a string.
Well, you look naked to me, Margo.
Well, they don't pay a hell of a lot if you wear an overcoat. For you, boss.
Just came in from talking to young Norman Kane.
Is that my cue?
Well, he liked your act. His whole party did. They want you to come back and do a private little show for him.
I don't go for that kind of scene.
Oh, come on, Margo. This guy's class.
Oh.
Comes from the finest families in the state. You won't get any kind of trouble there.
Boy, now there's a theory.
Man, Christ, it's not like I'm trying to get you to screw anybody. Just trying to pass a little extra money away.
What's in it for you, Chuck?
Keeping myself on the right side of the right kind of people. Now, you've been around long enough to know how that goes. Everybody owes somebody.
How much are they paying?
There's $100 in it.
Make it $150.
Hi. Mind if I come in?
No, sure. Come on in. I was just sitting around.
I noticed your wife's car wasn't there. Is she working late?
Kind of. You want a drink?
Yeah, well, I brought something along. You're a tequila man, I see.
Yeah. Kind of got used to it. Down in Mexico.
Well, Manuel, my wife's first husband, he was a tequila man. She made me promise I'd never touch the stuff.
Through my repertoire. You never know what turns some people on.
Chuck tells me you never drop your string.
Never.
Well, have a good time, huh?
On with the show.
I don't mean to be crude. Well, William, we in bed. I mean, me and my wife. I mean, actually in bed. She'll say things like, the garbage disposal broke again. I mean, right in the middle. She'll say things like that.
Hmm.
That's bad, ain't it?
It ain't good.
Your wife ever say anything like that?
Well, we don't have a garbage disposal.
Well, you're better off without one. Them things can fuck up a guy's nookie something awful. Your wife's a dancer out here.
Yeah, that's so.
Well, I hear she turns on a real good show.
She can shake it. No doubt about it.
This was our honeymoon trailer. I fixed it up myself when we first got married. Sometimes when it ain't rented, I like to come out here and just sit. Practice my whistling. I like to rent it to young couples.
I gotta go now. I'm gonna pick up my wife.
Where are you going?
I got another routine.
Why don't you forget the routine? Start from here.
Look, if you like bear ass so much, why don't you just watch them, huh?
So what do you think this is about? I just want to see your bear ass.
Well, then why else would you want to make me drop my string?
I want to bet $5,000. A grasshopper couldn't get out of a spoonful of money.
$5,000? Did it?
Of course not. Nobody gets out of a spoonful of money.
You want me to dance or not?
I want you to dance. No strings attached.
Forget about the string, all right?
I'm all for that. How much would it take to let you forget it? Why don't you think of it like an apron? When it comes off, you don't have to be the maid anymore. You'll just be naked like the rest of the guests.
What do you get out of this?
I don't know. Hasn't happened yet. And you don't know either. You know, it might not be such a big deal when it drops.
I don't dance bare ass.
We all dance bare ass, Marco. Just some of us don't admit it. 1,000. Wait a minute. Maybe 1,000 isn't enough. Why don't you just dance to the music, let it fall, and I'll pay you what I think it's worth. You just might get rich and liberated at the same time.
One more time.
It's time to quit, Margo.
Maybe we better let her inside that, huh?
Come on, let's go.
Well, Margo, I said I would pay you what I thought it was worth. Shall I settle up with you?
You are right on the edge, mister.
That puts all of us in the same place then, doesn't it?
Of the Tropicana. I was too short. Not lined.
Why don't you and I get married, Margo?
So you can take me away from all this.
Because I have nothing but good feelings for you.
I don't know how you survive so long in this world, Eugene.
Ran away.
Well, when we find this money, we'll both run away.
Left is the way to Tishomingo, right goes to Dollar, where that old couple lives.
That's not the place.
How do you know?
My father wouldn't bury it near two spooks like that.
What is it?
It's here.
What is?
The tree. We found it.
Well, tree, all right. The cottonwood.
Since when are you a tree expert?
I just said I don't think it's a cottonwood.
Well, it was behind a bank.
How do you know it was a bank?
Because it said so right on the sign out on the building.
Ah! This is it! I know it! I know it! Get the shovels, Eugene!
Let me loosen it up a little bit. Make it easier to get started.
There's no rush now, Margo. You take your time.
You're beginning to get some idea, Margo, just how much digging we got here. Even if we don't go any deeper than we are right now, it's gonna take us 2, maybe 3 days.
Well, what's your idea? We go hire a bulldozer?
Look, if you really want to do this seriously, you go back to town, you get provisions, and you just stay here as long as it takes.
Hey, look, while we're standing here arguing, we could find it if we were digging.
If this is the place!
God damn it, this is the place! You've been saying this isn't the place since we got here. This is the place.
If we find it, then this is the place. If not, it's just some sick old man dreaming.
Kill the battery.
Turn the light on. I can't see to dig. Turn the light on, goddammit.
How's that?
Fine. Come on, get digging.
This is not gonna work, Margo.
What do you mean you're not gonna work?
It's time to quit.
Quit? We just got started.
We're through. We're leaving.
So we can come back tomorrow and find out some other people stole it?
There's nothing to steal, Margo.
Nothing to steal? You liar! You goddamn fucking liar!
It is just something that he made up.
He didn't make it up. He wouldn't do that to me.
All right. Maybe he didn't make it up. Maybe he heard it or dreamed it or read about it someplace. Or maybe he just got confused after all these years. But whatever it is not what... Look at us! Will you look at us, for Christ's sake? I mean, we're out here sticking away like crazy people for buried treasure. There is no treasure, Margo! Except you and me be decent to each other. Don't you understand anything, you fucked up pathetic
bitch? Get away from me!
You know, you're wasting your life. And you're wasting mine. Don't you know every time you stand up there and take your clothes off, I want to cry at the sad sight you make.
You just want to rob me. That's all, you just want to rob me.
You're another worth stealing, Margo. You and your teaspring. It's supposed to protect your treasure. I mean, who wants it? Nobody except me. You're too fucking dumb to realize it. I'm the only stupid son of a bitch that gives a shit whether you're naked or not.
The show's over, Margot. It's all crazy.
This money's here and my daddy gave it to me.
It's crazy. Oh.
I will see you in jail.
I'll take you any place you want to go.
Oh. If you...
No.
If you're going to Roswell, you'd best get some stuff for this fella's shoulder.
I'll take you back to Roswell.
Sit down. Oh. Easy now. Easy. Oh. Sadie. Yeah. Sadie, wait a second.
Yeah.
Is it better?
Yeah. Yeah.
And you better get a little something extra.
No. Pan?
No.
Look, this boy is gonna need a drink before the night is out.
Oh. All right, now I'll take care of you. Just take it easy. Let me get that. What did she shoot you for? Had to be either love or money. But most likely both. You know, I tell you, if she'd have stood any closer, you'd have bled dry before we could have got you anyplace. Not too many more. Lucky for you, they were number 10s. Else they'd be the devil and all to come out.
These were nuggets, you'd be one rich, sick fella. Or I would. Seeing as how I'm the one to mine them. You know, I've been mining gold for the best part of 20 years, and I never had a pan this full before. Gold here. And before this is over, Charlie Parker will find it. You know, what some folks don't understand. What's for you won't go past.
Is it?
Of course it is. Good as gold.
Margo, you're on. Hey, Margo. You hear me? You got against the door, but if you don't get your ass out here, I'm opening the bitch. You hear me? Hey, Margo. Hey, what you doing here? You're fired.
Margo, you all right? Margo, it's Eugene. Open the door.
You hear me? We got a deal.
Uh-uh. Stay there, Chuck.
Music.